Yo, everyone get gas. You ready?
Guys, Fuad here, back in the building with another video. Today's session, it's going to be a bit of an investigation session because there's been a video that's kind of hit the mark all over the gaff. It's the Jake Paul video that went viral of him sparring. Now, we know Jake Paul's got a much anticipated match coming up against Nate Robinson. If you don't know who Nate Robinson is, he's an NBA player who's decided to lace up the gloves against Jake Paul. They had a bit of beef, a bit of altercation online, a bit of back and forth, but now they've decided to glove up and face off on the Mike Tyson versus Roy Jones undercard. I mean, call it what you want, but fair play for getting yourself onto that. I mean, that's just ridiculous. Like, that to have YouTubers and a basketballer who's never boxed on the undercard of, I know it's an exhibition, but those two are legends. I'm talking Hall of Famers legends, and you're going to be on the card. That's incredible, so fair play. But obviously, the reason why Jake's match is very anticipated is not just because of his following and everything, but we know that him and KSI are likely to get it on in 2021. KSI being undefeated in this whole boxing thing, and so is Jake Paul. Now, the sparring video. Before I get into it, I've got to give Jake the credit he's due. I mean, I'm a UK guy, as you can tell by the accent, and obviously I back KSI as a UK guy, as a homegrown guy. I've got to back my guy, KSI, and I've been following him for many, many years. You know, he's essentially inspired a lot of us to do what we're doing on YouTube. I'm going to support KSI, of course, but you've got to give credit where credit's due. I know Jake does some dumb things sometimes. He does some stupid things, right? But one thing about Jake is he's stuck down, he's put his head down, and he has been training. And it's not just the videos of him training. You can see the improvements in his boxing game. Now, I know JJ says that Logan's a much better boxer than Jake. I actually disagree with him on that. I think Logan's a good boxer in the way he tries to be technical, but I think Jake is coming along a lot more than what he did against Deji, was it 3 years ago now? He's improved so much. And if JJ's comparing those two, I can understand where that's coming from. Maybe Logan was better back then. But now, Jake's looking great. This video right here of him hitting the pads and to the body, I mean, the technique looks on point. His jab looks very good. You can't deny the fact that he's improving. Now, let's get into it. Sparring. Let me tell you one thing about sparring. All right, I've got the balls to go in and spar. Right, but have I got the balls to fight? Not as of yet. I'll be honest with you, I don't want to go get my head bashed in. Sparring is sparring, and we can see some sort of technicality being shown. Now, a lot of people are calling it fake. They're saying that it's set up, and here's what I'm gonna say. It's not set up. That is not set up. Let's have a look at the video in full speed. First and foremost, here we are, they're in the clinch and they let go. Jake bash, straight 1-2. It's a slick 1-2 down the middle, and if you watch it in slow motion here, as he comes off, backs off, the guy throws a lazy... Oh, no, he tries to throw a lazy jab. No, it's Jake's jab, actually. It's Jake's jab, which goes in first, which bops the guy's head back, and he tries to come with a left hook. Look at this. Jake rolls underneath it as well. He does... It's a Canelo-esque shot. Hits him to the head and rolls with the shot as well, which is fantastic. If anyone thinks that's set up, it's not. It's clearly not set up. He lands it. Now, let's go on to the Instagram post I posted on this about this video, and let's see what the people were saying about it. If KSI still throws a right hand, he's dead. KSI can throw. Let's agree with that. KSI's got power. He can throw a wild right hand. I've seen it many a time, and it can connect for sure. Let's see some more of the sparring videos. That I agree with that. If we're going to see that clip of you knocking this guy down, we want to see at least a full round. We want to see what you're actually doing. If you're going to show us knocking this guy down, show us more. Is his opponent any good? Okay, that's another very good question. His opponent may just be, and we couldn't really see much of him there. He didn't really throw a shot. His opponent might be a nobody. His opponent might be a guy who started box fit a few weeks ago. So that's a very good point. It's things like this we have to actually ask when we, you know, boxers essentially putting up videos of them knocking people out. Who is this guy? You need to know that, because then that kind of qualifies that knockout or knockdown to be good or bad. Cheap shot in sparring. That wasn't a cheap shot. That was it's a clean 1-2. Fake. People who think this is real. So we've got some people here who don't think it's real at all. Again, I've already made my point on that. It's very real. Someone said, I hate Jake Paul, but I think JJ is in trouble. See, this is the one thing as a JJ supporter, I was kind of worried as well. You see Jake training and getting better day by day, but we've not seen much of JJ training or anything. But he did make it clear in his new Reddit video that he is training.
I'm always training. Like, I haven't stopped training. Now that gyms are open, I can now, you know, like, do more boxing training as well. Really increase my ability. And yeah, don't worry, guys. Like, I've got this.
Just grafting lifting away secretly. He's not putting anything up, which essentially is better. Sometimes you don't need to put anything up, but you just go into the gym and do your, you know, do your bit and come out. He'll always be doing something behind the scenes that we don't know. That's why he's so successful at what he does. All right, let's look at his monthly listeners. I love this meme. Let's look at his monthly listeners. I mean, I know that JJ's got a lot more. JJ wins either way because he started all this boxing and look how many YouTubers he has inspired. I mean, that doesn't really make sense. Just because he's inspired the likes of the other guys to start boxing doesn't mean he's necessarily going to win the fight. But there you go. That's my answer to the question. Is it real? Is it fake? I think it's real, but there's many questions around it. Who's the guy? What's his boxing experience? Show us the rest of the round. But from what I can say, Jake is looking very good. I expect a top performance from him against Nate Robinson. And I'm sure JJ's training is arse off. And the fight in 2021 is going to be one to definitely catch, because the lead up to it is going to be incredible, I'm sure. And hats off to everyone that's getting into the ring. The YouTubers are doing their bits. Maybe one day I'll be in there too. You never know. Anyway, guys, I'll catch you on the next one.